This math exam is so difficult that the average score is a 2 out of 120.
Bruh. I don't know how first year undergraduates even enter the competition. My arch nemesis. Okay, so backstory, why am I doing this? Why do I want to do a Putnam contest competition? Close this, you don't want to see that. Janky tripod. Go right there. I'm so gung-ho about doing this Putnam competition because up until high school, like grade 11, I didn't even know you could go to the next level and then go to like a math Olympiad. Then I stumbled upon this entire subculture on YouTube, all these Olympiad people, and it looks so fun, and I missed out on it because I didn't even know it existed. We're gonna get good at math, and we're gonna do kind of well in the Putnam. Not English, obviously. And in order to do that, I'm gonna need to practice. And I looked at some questions earlier and they look fairly insane. Okay. Oh, and I'm late. Is like a lifestyle. When you're late, you run.
A million dimensions, it's linear algebra. It is because I have, for instance, these input output matrices, huh?
Yeah, I suck at math competitions. If you want to do any kind of study outside, the evening is the time to do it, or early in the morning. It's also nice and chilly. Okay, so grasshopper, that starts at the origin. So it's gonna have Cartesian plane, grasshopper dude. Where's grasshopper dude? Grasshopper dude starts at the origin. And then he makes a sequence of hops of length 5. So he's got like a radius of 5 that he can hop to. But it needs to be integers. So obviously he can hop here, here. Thus there are 12 possible locations for the grasshopper after each hop. I'm assuming we're using the triangle thing where it's like 3, 4, 5. So that would be 3 down, 4 across, so like there. And then 3 this way and then 4 down that way. Yeah, so then he's got 1, 2, and then 1, 2, and then what is the smallest number of hops needed for the grasshopper to reach the point? 20, 21, 20. It's a year question. We have the year. It's a year question. Oh boy. I'm probably annoying you if you're watching and you can do this question. Oh, nice cushions. Wait, I think I have an idea. So, see how this circle looks like a circle? At every point the grasshopper jumps to, Mr. Grasshopper jumps to this point, there's gonna be that circle around that point, which means if he jumps to this point, then he could jump to this point, and that's an integer point, right? And it's fully 45 degrees diagonal, and we're looking for a diagonal point because the points are the same. Let's say 2021, 2021 is all the way up here, okay? Which means that was 2 hops, and obviously going diagonally would be faster. So if you just go like a path like this, where he hops kind of diagonal, kind of diagonal, kind of diagonal until he gets to 2021. How many hops is that? Is that even 2021? So if that's, so that's 4, that's 3, which means he's traveled 5, but 4 horizontally. And then that's 3 and that's 4, So 4 plus 3, which is 7. 2021, is that divisible by 7? I think it is. No, it's not. Oh, damn. Well, nice. Oh, wait. Wait. Frick. It doesn't have to be 7. It could be, he could travel 4 and then 3. No. What? Yeah, 3 only. Like, it could be 7 all the way up until the end, and it just travels 3. So subtract 3 from that. 1, 2, 3. That's 2018. It's 2018 divisible by 7. No, it is not. Okay, I am confused again. I just realized how much wind noise there is. I'm moving inside. At least not that quiet, because there's no one here. Okay, how about how close can we get? And 3, 4, 3, 7. How many sevens go into 2021? The 288 times. Okay, and then 7 times 288 is... Never mind, I can do math. Okay, 2016. So we can get to the point 2016. And then if we want to get to 2021, we either just go 5 this way, 5 up, because then that's 5 plus 2016, which is 2021, right? And we could go this way. But still, it's the same two moves. So we get 288 moves. That's two moves. So it's 2 times 288. 576 plus 2 is 578. Add 2 because you do the 5 and 5 up at the end. So we get 578 moves to get to 2021. How is that the shortest path? I got it. Ew, my screen's all yellow. It's called nightlight. It helps me sleep. I gotta go to sleep. Okay. Anyways, what I was thinking is, the quickest way to get to this point here, diagonally to your nearest diagonal 45 degree point that's an integer coordinate, is this path directly. It's not going to be taking 5 and then backtracking or whatever. You have to go 4, 3, 3, 4. That's the quickest point there. Which also means that's the quickest point here, by going another 4, 3, and then 3, 4. Which also means that's a quickest point here, and you get the point, right? So it's always the quickest way to go 4, 3, and then 3, 4, and 4, 3, and then 3, 4. Or do it the other way, and you'll still get the same result. That's the quickest point to get to the point 2016, right? That's the quickest way to get there. Which means we're only left with figuring out how to get to 2021. That does not say 2021. And what's the quickest way to get to that? Obviously, it's just go 5, 5, because doing 3, 4, and then 4, 3, you have to do like some magic backtracking and you're never gonna get there. Like, in two moves, that is the shortest way. So it's like a recursive proof. So the shortest I did it. Okay. The shortest, ignore my handwriting, the shortest path diagonally to 2016-2016 is 100% definitely because I said so, 576 hops, and I showed you why that is, right? And then from 2016-2016, which is up here, to 2021-2021, yes, it's trivial that two hops is the shortest because you can't do it in one hop no matter what you do, so it must be two. Okay, that rhymed. And then you get 576 plus two extra hops to get to 2021-2021 is 578. Therefore, it must be 578 hops. Nice. I'm gonna just check the answer. We're doing the A session because we suck. I don't know if the B session is harder. Is this question one? E, that's the question, not the answer. Answer is 578. We are absolutely, we're above the median. Yes. Thank you. I'm actually really happy, even though I don't show it. On to question two. We're making this nice and big. This just looks like high school calculus. Wait, but there's an X in that. But there's an X in that. Okay. Whoa. One thing at a time, we are going to make... I cannot zoom in any further. We have to do this one first, right? And that's 1 over 0, which is undefined or infinity, I don't know. Damn, this quiet music. Yo, this is a vibe. Whoa. Okay, so basically you take the natural log of both sides. Yes. Okay, so you get this, and basically I'm also lazy here. I'm just gonna directly go to natural log of over r. And then we can use L'Hopital rule with the top. I haven't done any real analysis, okay? Do not judge me. Alright, so that's my guess. Let's try to cancel stuff out. I'm trying to do this a bit more rigorously and correctly. How do you do that limit? Bruh. You're gonna watch me sit here in pain. Okay, so I gave up. Yeah, and I looked at the answer and I got down to the absolute final step, basically. But I needed to know that the limit as x approaches infinity of this thing here is e. That's like a thing you need to know, that this of this is e. Obviously that's one, but yeah, I needed to know that, and I didn't know that. Well, okay, so considering I didn't know that the 1 plus 1 over x to the all to the power of x, the limit of that is e. And I got all the way down to right before where I needed to know that. I think I did pretty good. I don't know why the average score is a zero. Sorry, not the average, the median score is a zero. I don't know how that's possible. Maybe this is just an easy year or something.
Feet.